From the high-tech specs of Mars-destined rocket to the breakdown of its six-month trip through space, today we look at amazing facts about NASA's InSight Mars mission. Number 8. Scientific goals. In May of 2018, NASA launched a spacecraft to Mars with the mission to analyze and understand the origin of the planet and others like it. Equipped with top-of-the-line technology, this vehicle was meant to deploy a robotic lander that would descend upon the surface of the red planet. Once there, scientists expect the lander to measure the rate of meteoric impacts and seismic activity on Mars, as well as determine details regarding the crust, mantle, and core of the planet. While sending a seismometer to space has previously turned out unsuccessful, this $830 million project is expected to have worked out the kinks. Which is good news, as it remains the starring tool of the interior exploration using Seismic Investigations, Geodesy and Heat Transport mission, better known as InSight. Number 7. Spacecraft specifications. Space missions like these require a complex shuttle broken down into separate stages, and the InSight mission is no different. The rocket chosen to carry the lander to Mars was the Atlas V-401, a massive rocket built for interplanetary flight. When erected for launch, the rocket stands at an imposing 188 feet tall. When loaded down with all of the launch requirements, lander payload, and other equipment, this spacecraft weighs in at a staggering 730,000 pounds. That's three times the weight of a blue whale. The first stage of the craft is the Atlas V rocket, an element necessary for boosting and propelling the shuttle through the Earth's atmosphere. The thrust of the launch powers up to 850,000 pounds of full throttle and will accelerate the spacecraft to an insane 10,000 miles per hour. The second stage of the Atlas V-401 rocket is referred to as Centaur and takes over once the spacecraft is ready to enter Earth's low orbit. Referred to as the brains of the vehicle, Centaur has the capability to control its orientation precisely, and as such plays an important role when entering and exiting Earth orbit and beginning the journey to Mars. Liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen power the secondary engine, which can thrust the remaining stages forth with about 101,820 newtons of force. It also plays a key role in the third stage thanks to a flight control computer on board, granting it extreme precision. This final stage is called the payload fairing and is responsible for delivering the lander to the Mars surface. As such, it is the most important portion of the launch as it contains all the equipment necessary to conduct NASA's intended research. Number 6. Keeping contact. While the InSight Mars project is an operation of the United States government by way of the National Space Program, NASA, they wouldn't be able to perform this task without some international assistance. In order to remain in contact with the spacecraft, NASA utilizes a network of antennas spread across the world to reach recipient vehicles on interplanetary journeys. These three antenna complexes form NASA's deep space network and are spread approximately 120 degrees separate from one another around the world. In addition to being chosen for their distance from each other, these three locations were also picked for their geographical traits. All three are situated within mountainous, bowl-shaped valleys as a natural means to prevent interference from radio frequencies. Stationed in the Mojave Desert of California, near Madrid, Spain, and next to Canberra, Australia, these three complexes allow NASA to send precise signals toward the InSight craft no matter where the Earth is in orbit. The Deep Space Network connects with Mars orbiting probes, satellites, and telescopes to relay data to and from landers and rovers on the planet's surface. Number 5. Terrestrial planets. The main subject of the InSight mission is to evaluate the structure, integrity, and stability of Mars, as well as terrestrial planets as a whole. Rocky planets aren't especially common in our solar system, and as a result, little is known regarding their nature other than what we've gathered from our own planet as well as from past missions to Mars. While their structure may be similar, the main difference noted from retrieving samples is that each planet has distinct chemicals found in their respective cores, crusts, and mantles. These types of planets typically share the majority of their composition with meteorites. However, their development differs greatly from planet to planet. Typically involving melting and differentiation, this process of planet creation is still poorly understood. Factors like chemical composition, pressure, and temperature affect the outer portions of the planet as its molten surface crystallizes and cools. Some features, like the tendency for light minerals to rise to form the crust, and heavy features, sinking to form the mantle, are well recorded and comprehended, but many questions still remain. Atmospheric and surface composition, volcanic and tectonic activity, and potential magnetic fields require more thorough research, as these factors are determined by the first 10 million decades of the planet's development. And with that in mind, it only makes sense that this lander mission to Mars would be named InSight. Number 4. The Journey. The trip to Mars is a long one and can be divided into sections: pre-launch, the launch, the cruise, the approach, and the landing. Before the InSight project could even lift off, the path to their interplanetary destination took years to prepare. In 2011, the program was one of three finalists chosen out of 28 proposals to receive funding for further study. By the following year, the program was picked up for launch, and NASA was ready to begin funding its development with a spending cap of $425 million. But Lockheed Martin wouldn't begin construction on the InSight lander until 2014, with testing slated for 2015. Development of the seismometer meant for Mars had its share of issues and led to the launch being delayed from 2016 all the way to 2018. So from the time of its presentation, it took 7 years for the pieces to come together and get the InSight mission off the ground. From there, the journey would proceed to the launch phase, which took place in May 2018. The flight took off from Vandenberg Air Force Base in California and is the first of its kind to launch from this location. But this would only kick off the beginning of the 301 million mile trip. Once it's breached the Earth's orbit, the spacecraft then travels at a speed of 6,200 miles per hour along a curved route as it approaches Mars' orbital path. During this cruise period, NASA makes multiple adjustments to the craft's trajectory to make sure it remains on course across the nearly six-month trip. In addition to checking on its trajectory, NASA also closely monitors aspects like InSight vehicle's mechanical integrity, communication clarity, capabilities for the descent to Mars upon arrival, and other important components. All the while, they make calibrations and fine-tune any necessary issues from back on Earth. NASA engineers begin preparing for the approach and descent about 60 days ahead of the scheduled landing, and last until the craft enters Martian atmosphere. Here, the team focuses primarily on trajectory, and the deep space network is put to the test, as the amount of tracking data requested increases substantially in this late phase. On November 26, 2018, all this preparation and monitoring finally paid off when the InSight lander touched down on Mars. It safely made its successful descent onto the scheduled landing site of Elysium Planitia, an area of the planet chosen for its exceptional stillness and silence, allowing for more accurate data collection. Number 3. Tools of the trade. Now that the lander has come down to the red planet's surface, the payload is unleashed and the InSight mission is finally kicking into gear. The lander contains a variety of high-tech instruments to conduct the experiments and collect the data for transmission back to NASA engineers. The seismic experiment for interior structure, for example, is meant to measure seismic activity on Mars, referred to by NASA as Marsquakes. In addition to these precise measurements, the SEIS, as it's known, also records tidal forces generated by Mars moon Phobos. The heat flow and physical properties package is another tool aboard InSight that is used to delve deep into the ground to gather precise temperature readings from within the planet's subsurface, earning it the nickname of the Mole. A handful of other instruments on the lander are used to monitor the weather planetary spin, and other features of Mars that would give engineers and scientists a better understanding of the planet's nature. Demonstrating the collective effort required for this mission, components for these scientific tools came from all over the world, with contributions from French, Swiss, German, Italian, and British agencies and businesses. This just goes to show that the InSight mission is not just for the US, but the human race as a whole. Number 2, project size. The culmination of such a massive project would never have occurred if it weren't for the ingenuity and intelligence of the engineers and scientists that worked on the InSight program. And there were a ton of them. Four national agencies teamed to bring this project to life in the French CNES, the German DLR, the Italian Space Agency, and of course the American NASA. Independent institutions like the Jet Propulsion Laboratory, Imperial College of London, Max Planck Institute for Solar System Research, University of Oxford, and Lockheed Martin contributed to the project as well. In all, the InSight mission utilized the brightest minds from 11 different nations, including Belgium, Poland, Spain, and Japan. To promote this special collaboration, InSight has released a series of videos through NASA highlighting some members of the team to show off the unique qualifications brought to the table. Between the requirements for the launch, the journey, the landing, subsequent data collection, communications, and even specific members needed for InSight's various instruments, hundreds of individuals were involved. And after 7 years, they all received a sense of accomplishment in November of 2018 when the InSight lander finally reached the surface of Mars. Number 1. What we hope to learn. This mission to Mars is unique, not just because of the size of the project, the international collaboration aspect, or the specifics of the mission at hand. In addition to all those factors, the InSight mission proves special in that it will not just study a single planet or other astronomical bodies, instead focusing on particular issues occurring throughout solar system science. Mars is the perfect candidate to study for this information, as it's the right size to have experienced the early formation process of a terrestrial planet, but small enough to have retained data on this process not found on Earth. It's hoped that by analyzing the big red orb of Mars, humans might finally understand what it takes to create and evolve rocky planets.